Guys, this is S&P 500 weekly technical analysis for the week of July 1st. And the next week will be a very short week because the market will remain closed on 4th of July and on 3rd of July, market will remain open until 1 p.m. Now, last week we have seen that S&P 500 was struggling to move up and it was giving very limited bullish movement. On Friday, there came the favorable PCE data and core PCE data. And because of this favorable PCE and core PCE data, S&P 500 moved up and made an all-time high, approx 5524. And thereafter, for some reasons, it gave up heavily intraday. There wouldn't be any such problem if the S&P 500 would have stayed, would have sustained and closed around here. However, because of the closing below this level, the S&P 500 has lost the support of the MACD. And MACD is now bearish. At the same time, stochastic RSI is also bearish. This means that this bearish pressure is going to continue. However, we might not be able to see any good fall or any heavy fall. The reason is the weekly chart of the S&P 500, because on the weekly chart S&P 500 is still sustaining absolute bullish. And other than that, Dow Jones is also in a position or in a condition wherein it is also supporting a sustained movement and not a heavy fall. So definitely there are some conditions for the heavy fall or a short-term correction, a short-term reversal. But that will not be very easy because there are very, very strong support levels. So I will discuss all of these, the conditions of the bullish, bearish movement, the impact of the real impact of the MACD and the stochastic RSI in detail in this S&P 500 weekly technical analysis. So guys, if you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon. Now, before I discuss the agenda of this S&P 500 weekly technical analysis, let's see what we were anticipating last week and what actually has happened in the stock market. So this was my previous S&P 500 weekly technical analysis, and here I have discussed that for a bearish movement to happen, the S&P 500 at first must lose 5452 and then sustain below, and then there will be a fall. And if the S&P 500 sustains or keeps on sustaining above 5452 and keeps on closing above 5452, in that case, there won't be any bearish movement. Or even if there will be any bearish movement, then it will be limited. Rather, we will see either a bullish movement or a sustained movement. Now, guys, I am going to discuss the agenda of this S&P 500 weekly technical analysis. The first point of the agenda is the S&P 500 technical analysis on the weekly chart. Weekly chart means big picture, long-term picture for a month, for a quarter or so. On the weekly chart, S&P 500 is a little bearish but holding, absolute bullish, and it is still overbought and saturated. And almost the same condition was seen in the Dow Jones, the weekly chart of the Dow Jones. Okay, so weekly chart for now is indicating a little pressure, but eventually the market is expected to sustain. Now the second point of the agenda is the S&P 500 technical analysis on the daily chart. Daily chart means a short term picture for a week or for 2 weeks or so. On the daily chart, clearly the MACD is bearish, stochastic RSI is bearish. So we are anticipating some good pressure in the S&P 500. This means that any bullish retrace is expected to be limited. Rather, we can anticipate some more fall. This fall can be seen at most to around 5375, and there won't be any more bullish movement until and unless S&P 500 clears the 5524 mark, which was the all-time high. Okay, so I will discuss this in detail on this, the daily chart. The last point of the agenda is the probable movement of the S&P 500 from July 1st, which is Monday, to July 5th, that will be Friday. So whatever is going to happen in the S&P 500 from Monday through Friday next week, I'm going to discuss here. Now guys, there is one more thing. I recommend you to watch all of these, the three sections, because I discuss 40, 50 or 60% probable movement in these two sections themselves, along with the technical analysis. and the other 50-60% of the probable movement in the last point of the agenda. That is why, in order to get a clear picture that what is expected to happen in the S&P 500 and in the US stock market and why that is expected to happen in that particular manner. So I recommend you to watch all of these, the three sections. So guys, now I am going to begin with the first point of the agenda. That is the S&P 500 technical analysis on the weekly chart. So guys, this is the weekly chart. W as in weekly chart. Weekly chart means one candle represents 1 week, not 1 day or 1 hour. So before I discuss this, the candle, if you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon. And if you are looking for these daily precise updates of the S&P 500 from Monday through Friday every day, then you can join my Patreon community. I have given the link in the description of the video and also in the comment section. Now let's discuss the candle. If you look into this, the last candle, it's a small bearish candle, right? A very, very thin, very small bearish candle. It might look bearish, but in actual, this bearish candle is holding the bullish sentiments. Okay, so it's a special candle holding the bullish sentiments. Other than that, if you look into the weight and size of the candle, then it is very, very small as compared to these the candles. If you look into these the candles, okay, these were the heavy bullish or bearish candles, mostly bullish candles. Okay, and comparing these the candles, the last candle, okay, clearly it is neither heavy nor strong. So the question is that does this candle indicates or supports the bullish movement and not the bearish movement? No. That is not the case. The reason is that it looks like a bearish doji. Okay, see, this was a perfect doji candle. That is why we have seen a heavy fall here. Okay, in the week, and then I think on Thursday or Friday, last 1 or 2 days, we have seen a retrace. That is why this kind of candle was formed. Otherwise, the S&P 500 came down to 5192. So formation of this bearish doji indicates that definitely there is some pressure on the market. This pressure can force the S&P 500 to come down. However, because it's a technical bullish candle, and also it has failed to close below the open or the low of the previous candle, this means that whatever was the trend, this trend or the sentiments of the trend will remain in the picture. So what it means? This means that even though there will be some fall, okay, definitely there will be some pressure, but because of the bullish sentiments and the bullish trend on this the weekly chart, S&P 500 is expected to sustain to recover. Now this recovery may take, just like, okay, in this case, this recovery may take 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, but whenever it recovers, it is expected to recover strongly. This also means that even if the S&P 500 try to move up without coming down, even if the S&P 500 try to move up, then also it will remain under pressure and it will have to come down. So this is with the weekly candle of the S&P 500. Now if you notice, this is the weekly candle of the Dow Jones. So now if you look into the weekly candle of the Dow Jones, okay, it's a bearish candle, but the closing of the candle is again above the moving averages, and this is exactly what I have predicted in the previous S&P 500 weekly technical analysis, that any fall in the Dow Jones will be limited to the moving averages only. And again, we can anticipate Dow Jones to sustain, because if the Dow Jones loses this, the moving averages, in that case, there will be a heavy fall in the entire US stock market. So we have seen Dow Jones moved up, came down again and again. It has sustained at the moving averages on the weekly chart as well as on the daily chart. Okay. In this case, even though this is a bearish candle indicating that there is some pressure, not heavy, some pressure. Okay. Means that Dow Jones may again touch the moving averages, not a problem. But still it is sustaining above the moving averages, kind of slip is there. So it is again expected to sustain and to move up, not a problem. Okay. There are some conditions for the fall, but so far these conditions are not that much into the picture. So now the candle is clear. Candle is indicating some weakness, but not heavy weakness, some weakness only. And then eventually a recovery. Okay. Same here in the Dow Jones. Now, let's talk about the technical indicators. Technically, bullish, everything is bullish. Yes, S&P 500 is 100% absolute bullish on the weekly chart, just like it was in the last week. And at the same time, it is overbought and saturated. Okay, so exactly the same condition, nothing has changed on the weekly chart. S&P 500 is holding and sustaining. Okay. And the only problem is the overbought and the saturation. Okay, so there are chances, or there are some good chances, especially after the formation of this the last candle, that in the next week, especially in 1 or 2 days, S&P 500 may show some weakness, and because of that weakness, it can come down to test the moving average. Although the moving average will move up, and then it can come down to test the moving average, but eventually it is expected to sustain. In case of the Dow Jones, if you notice, Dow Jones, now that there are two candles above the moving average, is bullish. Fanout is bullish. This is also bullish. Yes, the MACD is still bearish. Okay, but now the point of relief is that the stochastic RSI is bullish. Although it is trading in the bearish territory, but still it has changed to bullish. Means stochastic RSI is against, or stochastic RSI is just opposite to the MACD. This means that there won't be any bullish or bearish support, or any bullish pressure or bearish pressure, because of the MACD or the stochastic RSI. But here, in case of the Dow Jones, Dow Jones is not 100% bullish, because the MACD is still bearish. Okay, and that and this is the big thing. Other than that, stochastic RSI is although it has changed, but again in the bearish territory. So here we can say that the Dow Jones is neither overbought nor saturated. Okay, and technically it will be considered 70% bullish on the weekly chart. Okay, so what we have seen here, S&P 500 is 100% bullish, absolute bullish, and the Dow Jones is 70% bullish. So overall, through the weekly chart, there is bullishness in the stock market. Okay, whatever was seen on Friday, okay, that was surprising. Now guys, I have one more information to share with you. This is my stock market knowledge transfer program, or the S&P 500 knowledge transfer program. Through this program, I teach the movement, strategies, trend, analysis, technicals, predictions, support and resistance levels, and much more. And the motto of this program is to help you become self-reliant. And whatever you are going to learn here, this is through the technicals, the patterns, the historical movement, etc. And this will be applicable to any stock, any index, any currency, any commodity, any crypto, or anything that is traded in the stock market. And also, this program is delivered one-on-one basis. And this is my email address. Whenever you want to participate, or if you have any questions that you want to ask, so you can simply connect with me here. This is the Google spreadsheet. More details are there in this, the Google spreadsheet. And when you open this Google spreadsheet, then you will notice that I have mentioned everything in detail, that what I'm going to cover, from the basics to the advanced, the technical indicators, the modified technical indicators, the options trading, basics, advanced, the options price calculator, and the options prediction, the price prediction in the options, and the option strategies, and how to deduce the trend of the stock market, and how to know the limits of the movement, everything. And these are the important terms and conditions, and these are the snapshots of the recent meetings. So guys, whenever you want to participate in this the program, I have given the link to this program in the description of the video and also in the comment section. And this is my email address. Whenever you want to participate, or if you have any questions, so you can connect me through this the email. Now guys, I am going to discuss the second point of the agenda of this S&P 500 weekly technical analysis. And here I will do the technical analysis of the S&P 500 on the daily chart. This is the daily chart, D as in daily chart. And here I will do the technical analysis of the S&P 500 on the daily chart. So daily chart means one candle represents one day, not one week or one hour. One candle means one day. So guys, before I discuss the candle, once again, if you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon. And if you're looking for these, the daily precise updates of the S&P 500 from Monday through Friday, then you can join my Patreon community. I have given the link in the description of the video and also in the comment section. Now let's discuss the candle. This is the last candle formed on Friday. We can clearly see that the S&P 500 moved up, made an all-time high of 5524 and came down and sustained and failed to hit the moving average. Okay, now this is a heavy bearish candle. Although there is no defined shape of the candle, okay, but it's a heavy bearish candle. Because of this heaviness, the bearish sentiments that were there at the time of closing of the stock market on Friday will be there on Monday. And this means that if the S&P 500 fails to get a gap up open, in that case, through a gap down open, S&P 500 will have to, or it must sustain at this, the moving average. Because losing this moving average on the daily chart, okay, means that now the S&P 500 will be forced to come down. And in that case, within a day or two, it can come down to test the 5375. And also, if there comes a gap up open because of European markets or the Asian markets, okay, then also the S&P 500 is expected to come down initially after open or within the first hour, okay, because of this heavy bearishness. So irrespective of anything, we can say that there will be some bearishness, okay, on Monday, right? But once again, I'm not saying that this bearishness will convert into a heavy fall and it will come down. No, because on the weekly chart, I have clearly discussed this thing that on the weekly chart, it is sustaining. It is absolute bullish. Okay, so there is no question of this, the heavy fall as of now. Now, when we look into this, the last candle of the Dow Jones, this is actually what is going to save the market. Now here the last candle, it is supporting the bullish movement, because you can clearly see after a bearish candle, okay, bullish and then a bullish supportive movement. Okay, what it means? This means that irrespective of anything on Monday, we can see a bullish movement. This means that even if there comes a gap down open, okay, in that here I'm talking about the Dow Jones. Even if there comes a gap down open, then also the Dow Jones is expected to recover. Or if in case there comes a condition of open equal to high. Open equal to high means immediately upon open, the stock market gave up. It came down. Okay. Or the Dow Jones or the S&P 500. Even if it comes into open equal to high condition, it will come down to test the Ichimoku cloud and then again it will retrace. So irrespective of anything, we are anticipating bullishness. Okay. Or an intraday recovery. But this comes with a condition, and that condition is that as of now the Dow Jones is trying to sustain bullish, and it has changed much into the the bullish side, okay, almost 80-90% bullish. But because on Tuesday it entered into the Ichimoku cloud, since then it has failed to clear the Ichimoku cloud, okay. So the Dow Jones itself has created a condition for the entire US stock market, or we can say that it has created a kind of a confusion in the stock market, wherein the stock market is bullish, but the bullishness is not guaranteed. And if you notice, this was my final update to my Patreon community members on Tuesday. Okay, final update is given 1 or 2 hours before the closing of the stock market, so that my community members, they can prepare for the next day. Now here I mentioned that if the Dow Jones closes below 39132, okay, that was the level on that day, means the Dow Jones has come into a dicey situation, and now the Dow Jones and the entire market, stock market, will remain dicey. And on that day we have seen some weakness in the S&P 500. So there will be some confusion whether the market is going to retrace or will it just give up. So this was clear that even though the Dow Jones is bullish, but its bullishness is not guaranteed. Even though S&P 500 was weakening, but its weakness or bearish movement is not guaranteed. So that is why we have seen some awkward movement for 1 or 2 days or so. And again, Dow Jones kept on closing inside the Ichimoku cloud. And again, there was a very limited confusing movement in the S&P 500. And we can say that this last candle on Friday in the S&P 500 in some manner is the result of, you know, that confusion. Although the exact reason was not known that why it has come down this much, surprisingly. So guys, this was with the candle, okay. Now let's discuss the technical indicators. So technically, as I mentioned in the beginning of the video, that here, the S&P 500 clear fan out, okay, or support, and everything is supported, bullish, okay. Now, MACD has gone bearish, and also the stochastic RSI has gone bearish. This bearish combination of the MACD and the stochastic RSI will put pressure or heavy pressure on the S&P 500, okay. And last time it was seen on 5th of June or 6th of June, okay. And the same thing I have conveyed to my Patreon community members, especially on, I think, Wednesday or Thursday, that if there comes a red candle on Wednesday or on Thursday, okay, in that case, the MACD will turn bearish. And this will happen after 5th June or 6th of June. This means that now we will anticipate some weakness in the S&P 500. Okay. But now it is clear, okay, that there will be weakness, and irrespective of anything, any bullish movement is expected to be limited for now. Okay. And then some weakness, it will come down, then it will hold, sustain, and will recover, and okay, this kind of movement. Yes, because of this, the last candle, last heavy bearish candle, the S&P 500 is now out of overbought. It is neither overbought nor saturated. Okay, so this is the good thing that has happened to the S&P 500, that it has now come out of the saturation and the overbought condition on the daily chart. However, on the weekly chart, it is still heavily saturated and heavily overbought. Okay. This means that we can anticipate some more fall, okay, little fall or so, and that will help the S&P 500 to come out of saturation and overbought condition on the weekly chart, okay. So I will discuss this thing in detail in the last point of the agenda. So on the daily chart, now we can clearly see that the S&P 500 has come into the 50-50 condition. 50-50 means neither bullish nor bearish, but it is in the bullish side. Why bullish side? Because moving averages and other technical indicators are still fan out, okay, and this and supporting this the bullish movement. So although it is 50-50, neither bullish nor bearish or neutral, but still this neutral is into the bull side. It is not in the bearish side, bull side. This means that anytime, okay, it can get a retrace and it can sustain. Now let's talk about the Dow Jones. Now here the Dow Jones, you can see, okay, again the same problem. So now here in case of the Dow Jones, you can see that moving averages, okay, there is a clear bullish crossover. Okay, this happened on Monday, especially on Monday. Okay, and since then it is sustaining bullish. Bullish here. MACD is bullish, and this is the important part, that MACD is bullish. Stochastic RSI is bearish, but if there comes a small, a little red candle or any kind of green candle, then stochastic RSI will turn bullish, and then this bullish, and then it will force and compel the Dow Jones to move up. Okay, on the daily chart, Dow Jones is neither overbought nor saturated. So on the daily chart, we can see that the Dow Jones is around 75% bullish. It is 75% bullish, okay. And this is important because if the Dow Jones remains bullish, in that case, even though we know that there is a disconnect that I'm talking for a month or so, okay, that there is a disconnect between S&P 500 and the Dow Jones, and this kind of movement wherein S&P 500 is coming down under pressure and Dow Jones is moving up, okay. So this is just because of this, the disconnect. But if the Dow Jones remains bullish, okay, in the near term, if it remains bullish, in that case, it will not allow the S&P 500 to come down heavily. any bearish movement, any fall will be limited, 0.5% maximum 1% or so, and then it is expected to recover. That is why Dow Jones, the bullish movement of the Dow Jones is necessary and is important for the entire US stock market to sustain and to remain bullish. Okay, but whatever will happen or whatever is going to happen, I will keep you updated through these, the daily and precise updates of the S&P 500, which I give to my Patreon community members every day from Monday through Friday. And it is not just limited to these, the daily and the precise updates of the S&P 500 from Monday through Friday. I also give these, the stock market opportunities in the premium stocks of the US stock market, minimum 5 to 10 every week to my Patreon community members. So guys, if you have not yet joined my Patreon community, then you can join my Patreon community in order to get the daily precise updates of the S&P 500 from Monday through Friday, as well as these stock market opportunities. And I've given the link in the description of the video and also in the comment section. And when you follow that link, then you will see that this is my Patreon page and this is my Patreon profile. And there are these two levels. This is the daily S&P 500 updates for non-US and Canada residents. This is the daily S&P 500 updates for US and Canada residents only. So whenever you subscribe to either of these, then you will be getting the daily S&P 500 analysis updates and the probable movement every day. And also the stock market opportunities minimum 5 to 10 every week in the premium stocks of the US stock market. And guys, if you notice that many people have joined my Patreon community for last many days, weeks, months, years, and they are getting these precise updates, the daily and the precise updates of the S&P 500 every day from Monday through Friday, and they are very well aware of what is going to happen in the stock market and why that is going to happen. So guys, whenever you want to join my Patreon community, I have given the link in the description of the video and also in the comment section. You can follow that link and you can join my Patreon community and you are welcome. Now guys, I am going to discuss the third and the last point of the agenda of this S&P 500 weekly technical analysis. And here I will give you the probable movement of the S&P 500 from July 1st, which is Monday, to July 5th, that will be Friday. So a few important things. Number one, that it will be a short week. Short week means first Monday, second Tuesday, third will be Wednesday, and Wednesday the stock market will remain open until 1 p.m. Okay, so it will be kind of half day. 4th of July is holiday, and on 5th of July there will be another session. Okay, so this means that we can simply say that there is nothing on 3rd and 4th of July, or I think 4th of July, the FOMC minutes of the meetings will be released. Okay, and these, the minutes of the meetings, will impact the movement of the S&P 500 and the entire US stock market. And on 2nd of July, the Federal Reserve Chairman is going to speak on the economic matters. Okay, and this will be in around, I think, 9:30 a.m. or 10 a.m. Means immediately upon when the stock market opens. Okay, so there will be some volatility. So we can say 1st, 2nd and 5th, only 3 days. Okay. And so, and generally whenever there comes a scenario like this, okay, it has no technical relevance, but generally whenever there comes a scenario like this, then the stock market, okay, it remains bullish generally, means 80-90% of the times. Okay, but again, there is no technical relevance, okay, to this. This is just through the historical movement and the patterns. And also on 5th of July, the non-farm payroll data, okay, that will be released. So guys, before I proceed, once again, if you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon. And if you're looking for these daily precise updates of the S&P 500, Monday through Friday, every day, then you can join my Patreon community. I have given the link in the description of the video and also in the comment section. So guys, in terms of probable movement, yes, let me remind you again that I have already discussed, okay, a lot of this, the probable movement in the weekly chart section and in the daily chart section. So if you have skipped these sections, weekly chart and the daily chart, then it is recommended that you should watch these sections. And also I've discussed that why we are still anticipating the bullish movement and a limited fall. Okay, everything through the weekly candle and the daily candles, and okay, so I've discussed there. as I've discussed on the daily chart, that because of this candle, so and also because of this the bearish doji kind of bear, it is not exactly a bearish doji, it's a candle in the bullish in nature, okay, but the shape of the candle looks like a bearish doji on the weekly chart. So because of this and these the candles, we are anticipating some more weakness in the S&P 500. However, this does not confirm any gap down open, or it simply indicates some bearish movement irrespective of any open. Right now the thing is that if there comes any kind of bearish movement in the S&P 500, and if the S&P 500 manages to hold and sustain, okay, at this the moving average, okay, in that case the bearish movement will be limited to the moving average and that's it, okay, there will be no more bearish movement. In that case the S&P 500 will hold, will sustain, okay, will give a closing above the moving average, and then on next day, that is 2nd of July, and then there will be the continuation of the bullish movement, okay. So this is the primary condition for the bearish movement, that if the S&P 500 loses this the moving average, okay, so this is very, very important, because once it loses this the moving average, then it will come under a kind of compulsion. There is not exactly a 100% compulsion, but a kind of compulsion wherein it can be forced to come down to fill the gap to 5375. Okay, so this kind of situation can come if it loses the moving average. Losing the moving average does not mean an intraday breach. No, this means a closing below the moving average. Only if there comes a closing below the moving average, okay, that will be the only case when we can say that if there comes one closing, that now it is weakening, and if there comes second closing below the moving average, two closing, means now most likely it is going for a short term, okay, fall correction, we can say 5375, towards 5375, okay. However, the Dow Jones is in a dicey situation. Dicey means a confusing situation. It is neither giving a clear picture in the bull side nor giving a clear picture in the bearish side. Okay, it is simply saying that the Dow Jones is sustaining and the market is sustaining. Okay, so even the bullishness is not confirmed, the bearishness is also not confirmed. Okay, although technically it is 75% bullish and it should trade bullish, but the bullishness is not guaranteed because of this the dicey situation. This means that even if the Dow Jones comes down, okay, Dow Jones can also come down. So if the Dow Jones comes down, but if it sustains and closes inside the Ichimoku cloud above this the lower band of the Ichimoku cloud, then S&P 500 will give up, but to a very limited, means it will lose the moving average, but it will close somewhere around 5400 410, you can say, or 541x, somewhere around that, okay. And then because the Dow Jones is sustaining in this case, and the Dow Jones will get a bullish reversal, then because of this the bullish reversal or bullish retrace or a sustained movement in the Dow Jones, S&P 500 may not come to 5375, and this the gap will not be filled. In that case there will be a reversal from here, okay, even though there will be one or two closings below the moving average, but the Dow Jones, as long as Dow Jones is sustaining above this the strong support level which is created by the Ichimoku cloud, okay, it won't allow a heavy fall, okay, in the US stock market, whether it's S&P 500, Nasdaq or any other index or so, okay. The problem will happen only when the Dow Jones loses the Ichimoku cloud, closes below the Ichimoku cloud and turns neutral 50-50, because in that case other technicals will also stop supporting the bullish movement, and once it goes neutral, in that case S&P 500 will not get any good support. In that case 5375 will be there, okay. So 5375 is a kind of, you can say, a technical obligation, okay, although there is a technical obligation at 4818, which is still not fulfilled, right? So this is what we are anticipating, that when there will be around 20% correction, okay, in the entire US stock market and in the global stock markets, that time the S&P 500 will be able to fulfill this the technical obligation to 4818. And 4818 was the all-time high when it was moving up earlier. Okay. So anyways, for now 5375 we are talking about. And one more thing, the S&P 500 will remain under pressure because of the MACD and the stochastic RSI. The MACD, I've discussed this on the daily chart, MACD and the stochastic RSI both are aligned bearish on the daily chart of the S&P 500. And because of this bearish alignment, there is bearish pressure. Okay. So now you must understand that if there comes no support from the Dow Jones, in that case, S&P 500 is compelled to come down to 5375 at least. Or if the Dow Jones comes down, gives a closing below, but then second closing or the third closing is back into the cloud, in that case, we can say at most 5375. That it will come down to around 5375 or 5370, fulfill its condition and will move up. Okay. So this is there in the bearish side. In the bull side, there are some strong conditions, okay, because of this fall on Friday. And because of this strong, and see, the very first strong condition in the bull side is that the Dow Jones must clear the Ichimoku cloud and must give a proper closing above the Ichimoku cloud so that it is free from this condition and there is no more confusion, and then it goes bullish. Because when it does so, in that case, S&P 500 will also get a relief, and even if it will come down to these the levels or limits, okay, it will get a bullish retrace. But now, any bullish movement in the S&P 500 will have to face a strong resistance at 5,500. Why 5,500? There is also a strong resistance below 5,500. And as of now, S&P 500 so far has failed to give proper closing above that strong resistance level. But let's keep it to 5,500. Because 5,500 is the psychological mark, is the psychological level. On this day also, we have seen it opened at 5,499.99, moved up to 5,505 approx, okay, and then gave a closing below 5,500. Again, struggle. Finally, on Friday, there was a perfect chance, perfect opportunity. Everything was aligned to the bullish side. Even the PCE, core PC data was favorable. Okay. But then for some unknown reasons, it gave up. So when the S&P 500 failed to sustain and close above, even when everything was favorable, this means that definitely there is something with the 5,500 psychological mark. Okay, this means that for now there won't be any more bullish movement, no bullish movement as such, or any bullish movement is expected to be limited to 5,500 or around 5,500. Once there comes at least one closing above the 5,500, let it be 5,500.01. This will also work. Okay, any closing above the 5,500, in that case, what will happen? In that case, it will start or it will begin its journey towards 5,600. Okay, 100 points more will then be added to the S&P 500 in the next month itself, or whenever it fulfills this condition, then within 2 to 3 weeks, okay, you can expect it to move up to hit the 5,500. But here you must understand that the technical analyst, okay, and everyone, okay, from United States, from Europe, and all of these experts, they're anticipating that at most S&P 500 can move up to 5,700 to 5,800 by the year end. This means that by the end of first half on June 28th, S&P 500 is around 5,500. Now in next 6 months, it can gain only 200 or 300 points. Okay, so this itself is very, very surprising that if the S&P 500 gained almost like 500 or 1000 points, 1000 points, okay, within 6 months, then now the all of the experts are anticipating that now there is a way, so there is a tight range, only 200 or 300 points S&P 500 can add in next 6 months. This means that during some time, okay, now in next 6 months, we are anticipating some correction, if not 20%, then 15 or 10% or so. So once it will come down and then it will sustain. And then by the year end, it will again move up, okay, and will try to achieve this 5,700 or 5,800 mark. Okay, so that is the most likely case that can be anticipated because of this, what the experts are saying. Okay, all of the experts, even the JP Morgan, Citibank, okay, Goldman Sachs, okay, and all of these, the HSBC banks, and everyone, they are anticipating at most, this is the at most, this is the maximum S&P 500 can gain, okay, by the year end. Yep, so if I continue with this, if the experts are saying that this is the maximum S&P 500 can achieve, in that case, there are two scenarios that we can anticipate. Number one, either S&P 500 is going to continue with the current bullish movement, okay, it will add more 50 points or 100 points, 5,600 or so, okay, and then it will go for a 20% correction or so, and this correction will be seen at least for 3 months, fine, and then there will be the recovery. Then this recovery, okay, will happen in next 2 months or 3 months, then this recovery will help the S&P 500 to move up and to move towards 5,700 or 800 by the year end. Okay, so that is the scenario. The second scenario is that S&P 500 should give up now, okay, from the first week of July or the second week or the second week of July. It should enter into the correction, give 15-20% correction, okay, and then July, August, September, October. Okay, so elections are there. Then from October, around October onwards, it should move up sharply, okay, irrespective of who is going to win. Okay, it should move up, and then by the year end, by December 31st, it should be around 5,700 or 800. Okay, so in both of these the scenarios, looks like S&P 500, technically also it is demanded that S&P 500 and the entire US stock market, okay, let's say that simply the entire US stock market should go for 15-20%, okay, 20% a technical correction, okay, in next 3 months, okay, and then it should recover, right? So but for the next week, this is the bullish condition. Okay, I mentioned 5,500 is the strong mark. This condition must be fulfilled. One closing above 5,500 and then it will move up. Then it will move up to what? It will move up to 5524. 5524 was the all-time high level of the S&P 500, which it has gained on Friday. And you'll be surprised to know that 5525 is my calculated resistance level. And in my pre-market update and on first update also on Friday, on June 28th, to my Patreon community members, I've again and again mentioned that 5525. Okay, so it is the S&P 500 is going to face heavy resistance at 5525, and at or around 5525, it will hold, it will come down. Okay, then it, and when it comes down, then it will retest another heavy support level. Once it sustains, once it cools down, because it was already stretched, okay, or it was overstretched. So once it cools down the technicals, okay, in that case, it will come to the 5525 again, and then 5525 will be tested. And then only once a sustained movement happens above 5525, chances are less. Okay, but if there comes heavy pump and if it happens, then only we can anticipate that there will be some more bullish movement above 5525, else it will remain up to or around 5525. And you can see S&P 500 has achieved or has gained a maximum of 5524 and failed. So this 5525 and others, These are not the standard support and resistance levels. These are my calculated support and resistance levels, which I share with my Patreon committee members, okay, on the daily basis. And the movement is generally, okay, in between these the levels. So the bullish movement is clear, bearish movement is clear. So Tuesday, when the Federal Reserve Chairman is going to speak, okay, it will be, the picture will be, so the picture will be clear whether the market is going to sustain bullish or bearish, okay. And there is one more thing, if the stock market sustains and sustains bullish on Tuesday, okay, then most likely for the entire week it is going to sustain bullish, okay, irrespective of the outcome of the FOMC minutes of the meetings and the non-farm payroll. Friday through the non-farm payroll, there may come some variation, but eventually, okay, in this case, it will sustain. But whatever will happen or whatever is going to happen, I will keep you updated through these, the daily, in the precise updates of the S&P 500 every day from Monday through Friday. If you are my Patreon community member, and if you have not yet joined my Patreon community, then I've given the link in the description of the video and also in the comment section. You can follow that link and you can join my Patreon community. So guys, hit like if you like this video, and if you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon. So guys, this was my S&P 500 weekly technical analysis for the week of July 1st, means from July 1st, which is Monday, to July 5th, that will be Friday.